Maybe we should just get to the poems. You guys now write these poems yourself?
Yes. We steal the ideas.
Steal the ideas. Well, that's all right. Who wants to start?
Go ahead, Mr. Sweet.
I'll start.
Okay.
Most of mine have something to do with my past experiences, and this one's a little more recent. As you get along about this far in life, you're more conscious of your personal health, and you kind of get to watching the Quaker Oat commercials. Mm-hmm. And Wilford Brimley's not only one of my favorite actors, but he's one of the good old boys. He can still ride a horse and nail shoes on it if he has to, and so that kind of inspired this one. I call it Feeling My Oats. There's a good thing going for my heart. I'm eating oats 3 times a day. If I ate that much wheat, the soles of my feet would look like runners on a sleigh. 14 kids are making bets on when their grandpa bloats, and it's all because of Wilford and his cholesterol-killing oats. I carry nitro in my pocket. I'm just a bomb that's wearing boots. My doctor and my pharmacist are magicians in cahoots. They've prescribed at least 12 pills, and I've taken quite a few. But now I'm eating like a horse because it's the proper thing to do. There's oatmeal in the homemade bread. It's in the cookie dough. My wife, who used to say, "Good morning, dear," slaps my rump and hollers, "Whoa!" But now I'm wondering about my racehorse. He eats from that same sack. And he was only 8 years old when we pulled him off the track. But the oats are working fine for me. I feel like I'm 22. I'm far from dead because Wilford said eating oats is the right thing to do.
Very good. I like that. Okay, that's hard to top.
I know.
Hey, you got a tough act to follow there, Rod. So it's your turn.
Well, this is a stolen idea, as I told you before, Mr. Carson. It's called Mad Jack's Dog. Mm-hmm. It's along the same idea as a sanitation. It was a short and squatty cabin, thick dirt roof and round corral, but from the distance it looked interesting. I stopped to rest my horse a spell, and from around behind the cabin, this wild-eyed old-timer came, said that he was Mad Jack Hanks. I shook his hand, told him my name, said he was up there trapping beaver, and that he had the lonesome blues. Soon he offered bed and breakfast if I'd share the latest news. I agreed to his proposal. He seemed glad to have me stay. He was rustling up some tableware while I put my horse away. He had the supper going. I hauled in a load of wood. I shared the latest current events, and things were going good till I reached down to pet his damned old dog. I truly meant no harm, but before you knew it, that old wolf had bit me on the arm. Now, I just took it slow and easy. Figured I could make us friends, 'cause few dogs resist my shrewd attempts to make amends. But this old wolf just shows his teeth to me. Acts like he might attack. I finally took the hint and moved my stool around by Jack. "Mad Jack," I said, "why does your dog just glare at me with hate?" "Oh," he says, "it's nothing. It's just you're eating off his plate."